Headline inflation cooled for the second month in a row in August, hitting an annualized pace of 7%. This came in lower than economists' expectations of 7.3% and slipped from the 7.6% reading in July. However, this is still too hot for the economy to handle, and economists are wary of core inflation pressures. Let's break down the data. The drop in the consumer price index was largely led by decelerating gasoline prices, which rose 22.1% in August from a year earlier. This came in lower than July's 35.6% year-over-year growth. On a monthly basis, Canadians paid 9.6% less at the pump for gasoline. Prices fell as oil-producing countries hiked production. However, the news isn't all good. The price of groceries rose 10.8% since last August, hitting the fastest pace since 1981. The rise in food prices was broad-based, hitting meat, dairy, baked goods, fruit, non-alcoholic beverages, condiments, sugar, and seafood. This comes as food supply struggles under poor weather conditions, higher input costs, and supply chain disruptions from the Russian invasion into Ukraine. Travel and accommodation costs remained elevated but rose at a slower pace in August with a year-over-year growth of 33%. While this marks the second month of declining CPI figures in a row, the number still stands high above the Bank of Canada's 2% target. Some economists are still expecting the Bank of Canada to deliver another outsized rate hike in October. Economists added that these figures are a welcome sign that some price pressures may be easing, but warned that we're not out of the woods just yet. The core numbers that aim to smooth over volatile prices like gasoline also cooled in August, but still remain too high for the Bank of Canada. The average core inflation reading slipped to 5.2% year-over-year in August from the 5.4% annualized pace in July. Similarly, Stats Canada noted that prices excluding gasoline eased from July's 6.6% reading to 6.3% in August. While the August data is mostly a gasoline story, economists are wondering if this is the light at the end of the inflation tunnel since 7% CPI is down from the 8.1% peak in June. The Bank of Canada will factor this August data as well as other upcoming economic data in its next rate decision in late October.